But I really like it. You know what I'm saying? It's great. I'm learning a lot. Learning a lot more. You know, coming from UC, don't get me wrong, I never speak bad or ill will about UC, because UC prepared me for the world. That's, you know, in life and in work field, because you get a little bit of taste of everything in UC, like racism, everything. You get a taste of that, you know, classism, you know, all them isms. But I will never, ever, ever not think, you know, be thankful enough to have that, had those positions at UC. Like I said, it taught me one thing is always be thankful for who you are and stay true to who you are, because places where you get complacent, you know, those are like the rough, those are really rough. You know what I'm saying? It's like, oh shit, did I miss the wrong turn? No, I'm going right. Oh, I was about to say, it's over. But like I was saying, it's rough. The being complacent in places like UC, you know, it can really get you to be very negative. Like the culture, a lot, not the culture, but a lot of the people are. It's good and bad in everything, in everywhere you go. It's good and bad. But like today, really, really, like, it just really opened my eyes to how, you know, corporations do and doing, not corporate, I'm not going to say corporation, I'm going to say company people. People who want to be company, want to go by every rule. Not even, and that's not a bad thing, but at the same time, we human, we make mistakes, but it's like there's no room for mistakes. You can't do that. It's almost like, you know, you were in that position before when you was making mistakes. So what gives you the right, or gives you the, who do you think you are to just sit back and be able to say, like, you know, oh, you shouldn't do that. It's this and me and me and me and this and that. I get it. Like, I've been there. Like, man, you can't tell me how to do it. You can't tell me it's not hard. I've done it. I know it's hard, but you can do it. But that's what I'm learning today. I learned that everybody doesn't think like Josh. Everybody doesn't see the good in people like Josh. And I really had to thank my mom and my grandmother, you know, for that. You know, I'm gonna say my mom, because Granny was, Annabelle was crazy. Annabelle was Annabelle. But Pam, mom, taught me, always try to see the good in people, no matter. This is a great teacher. It teaches you a lot. You know what I'm saying? I said through life, through marriage, through anything, life teaches you a lot. So, with that being said, I learned a lot today. Today I experienced I experienced not trying to get my first impression of this person by the way they acted. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I think I overreacted just a tad bit of what she said. And I took it, and I let it marinate on me while I was driving. Now I feel like, you know what? That's how she do it. I'm going to let her do her, as long as she don't, you know what I'm saying? As long as it don't affect me, you know what I'm saying? Or my people, whoever I have. You know, I'm going to continue to learn to be the best manager I can. And, you know, just being a better person, man. Because in this field of work, managing people, you have to have a heart. You have to be able to relate. Not even relate to their situation, because sometimes you've never been through what this person's going through. But just able to have some compassion. Like, a lot of people can say, oh, I'm so sorry for you. Or until you go through, in my personal opinion, until you go through what some of these people are going through, you can't really say, like, oh, you can't really judge them. I'm not going to say you can't say sorry, because you should say sorry. But you can't judge them off that, because you don't know. You've never been through, you know, what they're going through. So you can't justify why you feel that way. So with that being said, I'm saying that because I think I overreacted just a tad bit too much. And I think I'm going to learn. I'm going to take the situation of how I, from a teammate, and learn from it. So going to end that video on a positive. One thing I've always tried to do in my life is make everybody who's ever taught me something proud of me. And that's from anybody, from managers, football coaches, teachers, family members, you know, anybody. You know what I'm saying? So what I want to say is, when you have a tough day at work, or you experience something at work or at home or whatever you're doing, just realize there's somebody out there that's way worse than you have. And that's one thing I always try to realize when I'm down about money or bills or whatever, or anything, that there's somebody out here that has it worse than you. Because it's always, grass always looks green on the other side, but it might not be. And sometimes you just gotta take your storm that you're going through head on and keep fighting, because at the end of the day, it's like, you never know. You know what I'm saying? You never really know what the issue is or what it is. You know what I'm saying? I can't put it in words for you. So I'm gonna try to do this a little more often, you know. Getting better with it, you know. I'm gonna vlog a little more, but I appreciate y'all riding with me, you know, letting me get off my chest while I'm going, you know, with my wife. So I appreciate it.
So I'm about to get furniture today, and I thought that I would get our furniture today, and I thought that I would do a empty apartment tour of the trap house we have been living in for the past 5 or 6 days. I'm hot because I just put everything up so that the movers can get in and stuff. They should be on their way. They're supposed to be here between 8:30 and 9:30, and they got there really early to pick up our stuff in Cincinnati. So hopefully they get here really early to drop it off. So, without further ado, here's the trap house. that is really it for the Unfurnished house tour.